In business news, the Nigeria Electricity Regulatory Commission, NEC, says it has no plan to increase electricity tariff. The chairman of NEC, Professor James Momo, spoke to newsmen in Abuja, saying the review of electricity tariff does not automatically mean increased payments by customers. Professor Momo said tariff review is a constitutional obligation of the commission, and it helps to determine the level of intervention needed in the sector.
There is no immediate increase in tariff for customers. The proposed tariff review, is what we are mandated to do as a regulator. We have to do it twice a year. We've done the first one around June. January is here, thank God. That is what we have no ability, we have no other option but to do our job. But don't take us for granted, we must do our job. We have done the review, and it's subject to public consultation in the next 3 months. Dr. Arabi, the entire commissioners, and myself will be running from place to place to inform you, to engage you, just like we've done our job for consultation.
This review does not necessarily translate to increase in tariff. What it does is that the participants and the discos and even the GENCOs would come to know what cost-reflective tariff is. So, it will determine how much the discos remit to the market and how much interventions will be required.
Earlier, PLUS TV Africa spoke to Femi Faduba, head of business development, cross-boundary energy, and reacted to this development.
Okay. I understand why people are frustrated and concerned by it,
and also angry.
But I also understand the justification of why this country might need to increase tariffs. So I think that it is worth saying, you know, let's wait and see. You know, in most countries, including Nigeria, it's a bit weaker here, you have a social contract. Right, between the citizenry and the government, whereby I, as a taxpayer, I pay taxes, and you know I pay maybe more in electricity fees.
Yes.
In return, as a government, you give me services, public services, and also reliable power.
Now, you say you feel the hike, the proposed hike in tariffs is justifiable, but an average Nigerian feels the present poor and epileptic power supply do not justify an increase in the tariffs. How do you match those two? How do you agree?
I understand. Well, look, first of all, I'm not necessarily saying that it's justified. What I'm saying is there is a world in which the government takes the first step in building that social contract.
Yes.
I think if most Nigerians believed that by paying more for power, they would have reliable power, let's say 100% power all day, every week, then I think we'd have a completely different discussion on our hands right now than what we have right now. The issue is the lack of trust. The issue is the fact that most people don't believe that come this time next year, come this time 2 years from now, that increase in tariffs would have led to a measurable increase in the value of the power being provided.
Hmm. All right, NEC also explained in a statement that it doesn't intend to increase tariffs, but do a retrospective adjustment of tariffs. How do you react to this?
Yeah, I mean, it's an interesting statement. I think it's a bit more in the semantics. What they're really saying is that
a play of words?
Yeah, a bit of a play of words, probably a generous way to put it. What they're saying is that the currency, the Nigerian Naira, when compared to the dollar, has devalued. And so they've adjusted for that.
Okay. Now, has the privatization of the sector achieved the purpose intended? And how can the federal government actually tackle the bottleneck associated with the distribution of the electricity in Nigeria?
Sure. I mean, I think if you ask most people working in this space, they would say that the privatization hasn't led to the results that we expected.
Yeah.
You know, as of January 2nd, the number of gigawatts in terms of generation capacity in this country was 3.6 gigawatts, right? And that really hasn't moved. In fact, it's come down a little bit in that period since the privatization happened. And
okay.
So I think it's been disappointing in terms of outcome, but who knows? Maybe we're at the start of a promising road.
Okay. Now, would you say it's more of a generation problem or a distribution problem?
I mean, it's all connected.
Okay.
Right? So at the very end, you have the end user who pays money to DISCO, and then the distribution company pays money to the transmission and grid company. The transmission grid company then pays money to the generation company. And so if at this end is broken, then the whole pipeline is affected. So if you ask anyone in any segment of that chain, they'll all complain and say that there's seriously.